FRMCS, or Future Railway Mobile Communication System, is intended to be a successor to the existing GSM-R standard, and that is, it's intended to support the quite complex communication requirements of a modern railway system. So we may have commuters using a train that have demands for high data rates and low levels of latency to ensure that they can access multimedia content. We also have the concept of driverless trains, for example, and also safety systems which rely on mission-critical real-time communication. So let's take a look at some of the key use cases then where we might see FRMCS deployed. So first of all, we have CCTV offload. So within many trains nowadays, there are trains that capture real-time video imaging, which can consume large amounts of storage space. And it simply wouldn't be feasible to have this stored on a train for what may be a potentially extremely long journey. So one of the solutions that we have here is to offload this CCTV footage when the train arrives at a station. So FRMCS can facilitate this communication link where the train will communicate with a system located perhaps within a major station that will then ensure that the CCTV data captured on the train itself can be securely stored and uploaded to another location from within the station itself. So this essentially ensures that there is no need to keep large amounts of storage on train for the benefit of maintaining CCTV footage, because we must remember in some jurisdictions, in some countries, there may be a requirement on the train operator to retain CCTV footage. Next, we have automated train control. So for autonomous train services, it's essential to be able to maintain a highly available, secure, low latency data link that can also support high data rates when required. And this is, of course, essential when we consider things such as critical safety systems within these trains. Next, we have multimedia services. So in addition to the services that a user may be able to access via their existing cellular provider, there is also the opportunity for train operators to serve and provide multimedia content to their travelers. And this can be done in very much a similar way to CCTV offload, albeit in reverse. So when a train enters a station, for example, multimedia content stored locally within the station can be uploaded to the train's multimedia system utilizing that FRMCS communication. So once again, this ensures that we don't have to have huge amounts of storage on the trains, and multimedia content can be loaded at different locations along the route. And then finally, we have cellular coverage. So there are many examples already that use different systems to provide cellular coverage or to extend cellular coverage into environments where signal propagation is likely to be extremely poor or non-existent. So in underground systems, for example, or through tunnel environments, train providers are able to extend this coverage utilizing different methods. So we may see the use of leaky feeder cables, for example, where we have cabling that essentially emits a radio signal. But we may also see modern solutions that we might see in other private cellular environments, such as DAS distributed antenna systems. But ultimately, this is about ensuring that train users, train travelers are able to access a full range of cellular coverage regardless of the environment that the train is in. And of course, trains themselves may also move through countryside environments, rural environments where coverage isn't likely to be as good, or coverage provided by their mobile service provider isn't likely to be as good. And thus this can be supplemented by the train operators or the organization responsible for maintaining the railway infrastructure, for example. Finally, let's take a look at some performance requirements in different scenarios within a railway system. Now, what we should say at the outset here is you may notice these different communication types or these different scenarios are based around the concept of mission-critical communication, which is defined separately within the 3GPP specifications. So we have mission-critical push-to-talk, which is used for mission-critical voice. We have mission-critical video and mission-critical data scenarios, which we can clearly map to the different communication scenarios or communication types that we see here. So if we pick out some of the key figures then, so typically within an FRMCS system, we're likely to see a latency of sub 100 milliseconds. Now, the exception here are safety-critical systems. So If we look at very critical video communication, for example, we can see that actually this will vary depending on the scenario. So the situations where the train safety itself is directly impacted, we see much more stringent requirements in terms of latency. We can see that reliability is typically 99.9% uptime, although again, this can be varied for different scenarios. So again, where we have systems that may be impacted, such as safety systems, where it's absolutely essential that we try and maintain uptime, we can see further levels of reliability there. In terms of the supported speed limit, if you're familiar with the 5G specifications, you'll know that we can support up to 500 kilometers per hour. But again, in these scenarios, this will be dependent on the scenario itself as to whether we can actually achieve that speed limit or that mobility speed. We can see for user experience data rate, this can be adjusted or will vary depending on different scenarios. We have area traffic density, so the amount of traffic that can be supported within a particular area in terms of throughput. And then finally, the service area dimension. So, you know, how big an area can we provide this service? So we won't go through each one. The video can be paused for you to examine each of these performance characteristics in turn. But what we can see then is we're able to provide a diverse set of performance parameters, if you will, for lots of different scenarios that may be encountered within the rail network. So in closing then, essentially FRMCS is designed to bring the enhancements of 5G to railway systems and thus replace the existing GSMR for railway standard.